land. So we learn about our country India today. So children, open page number 21 in your textbooks. So India, our motherland. Let us know about our motherland India. You will notice that the surface is not the same everywhere. There are mountains and plains. Some parts are rocky while some are sandy. India's land surface is made of mountains, plains, hills, plateaus and deserts. So, let us learn more about our motherland, that is our country, India. So, actually, if you observe the surface, surface means the land area, everywhere is it even? No, it is not even. Some places you can see mountains, some places you can see rivers, some places you can see plains, right? So, it is not even. So, there are many mountains and plains in our country. So first, not only mountains and plains, we also have hills, plateaus and also deserts. So first we learn about mountains. So the north of the India, you see Himalayas. They are the highest mountain ranges in the world. So mountains. So you know mountains, right? Big hills. So mountains. In mountains, Himalayas. You can see the Himalayas in the north of your country. They are the very highest, very big range of mountains in our country. So Himalayas are the highest mountain ranges in our country. Not only in the country, they are the highest mountain ranges throughout the world. So they form a natural boundary in the north. The peaks are covered with snow almost throughout the year. The highest peak of the Himalayas is Mount Everest. It is in Nepal. Do you know it is the highest mountain peak in the world? Many rivers such as the Ganges, Yamuna, Indus, Satluj and the Brahmaputra have their origin in the Himalayas. The climate around these mountains is very cold. So, this Himalayas, they form a natural boundary in the north. So it separates, if you observe the Nepal and the so it forms a natural boundary. So apart from that, see, Himalayas are, as I told you, Himalayas are the highest mountain ranges in the world, right? So in the Himalayas, you know, there is one Mount Everest, which is the highest peak in the world. And you know, it is located in the country Nepal. Not only that, there are many rivers like the Ganges, Ganga, Indus, Yamuna, Satluj and Brahmaputra. They all originate, means they start, they are born there. Origin means they are born there. Which rivers are originated? Ganges, Yamuna, Indus, Satluj and also Brahmaputra. They are originated from Himalayas, means they are born from Himalayas. So for us, India is our motherland, right? So like that, only for these rivers, Himalayas are the motherland because they are originated from there. And you know, the climate around Himalayas is very cool because there will be always snowfall, and you know, these mountains are totally covered with the snow. Next, there are mountain ranges in the central and southern parts of India too. So there are some mountains in the central, which is the south part of India. So the Vindhya and Satpura ranges in the central India, by Nilgiri hills are in the south. But these mountain ranges are not high as the Himalayas. So towards the south, you have Nilgiri hills, and towards the center of India, you have Vindhya and Satpura mountains. What mountains? Vindhya and Satpura mountains are at the center of India. And towards the south part of India, you can see Nilgiri hills. And anyway, these three hills are not as big as Himalayas. So throughout the world only, Himalayas are very big mountains. See here, you can see the picture of the Himalayas. Next, plains. As we move to the south of the Himalayas, we see flat level land called plains. So when we move towards the south direction of Himalayas, you can see occupies very large area of north and eastern part of India. Rivers like, as we all have discussed, that Ganga, Yamuna, Indus, Satluj and Brahmaputra, they are originated from Himalayas, right? So towards the south, which rivers flow? See, Ganga and Yamuna, these two rivers flow towards the south part of the India. And you know, at that place, why they flow towards that place? Because to make the place green, means to help the farmers grow crops well, to avoid the scarcity of water, like that. So they are very helpful for making the region green and also fertile. And you know, they, in these regions, the summers are very hot and the winters are very cold. Along the eastern and western coast of India, there are plains. These plains meet at Kanyakumari, which lies in the southernmost tip of India. So along east and west side, actually if you look at India map, top will be north, south, east and west, okay? So here towards the north part of India, you have, see here you have the India map, right? So here towards this, towards the north, here you have the Himalayas. So from the Himalayas, many rivers are originated. On top of that, see, Ganga and Yamuna flow towards the southwest, they come downward direction like this. Next, rivers like, see, towards the east and west of India, there are some other plains. These plains meet at Kanyakumari. So you know where is Kanyakumari? It is in Jammu and Kashmir, right here. So they meet at Kanyakumari. And the which is the southernmost tip of India, rivers like the Tapti, Godavari, Mahanadi, Krishna and Kaveri flow through these plains and flow into the sea. In the coastal regions, the climate is neither too hot nor cold. So many rivers like Tapti, Godavari, Mahanadi, Krishna and Kaveri flow through which plains? They flow through the east and western coast of India. And you know, the climate in that places is not very hot, not very cool. Here you can see the picture of Indo-Gangetic Plain and also Kanyakumari. Next, we'll see about plateaus, deserts and islands in our next class.